Everybody inside him has that dream. Everyone in the Philippines has that dream that the Philippines can excel in track cycling. Because we have previously in the past, di ba? As recently as sila John Mayer, sila John Paul Morales, they have excelled in track. And looking at our neighbors in Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, they also excel in track. So there's no reason why we cannot excel in track. And to answer your question, I had a conversation with Mayor Bumble during the Philippine National Games during the National Championships. And he had already mentioned, I don't know if I'm allowed to tell you this, but he had already mentioned that they are going to be building a velodrome in Tagaytay City very, very soon.
And you're supporting that?
Of course, of course. It is something that we really want to happen, and then if and when na-accomplish na yan, we will give our full support to the Philippine track cycling team.
Yes, James, may question ka pa? One question?
Good afternoon. If I remember correctly, Go for Gold was conceptualized and visualized by Mr. Carlos when he was at Philpost. And I know that. Lobby Carlos. So now.
Wait, James. Before we have that CSI Criterium series, pero hindi siya Go for Gold under Lumi Carlos Parkour. So that's a different Criterium series.
You know, now you are at the helm of Go for Gold, and the only way to gauge the skills and competitiveness of the Philippine cyclist is to send them abroad. Are there many competitions for this year in preparation for the 2025 SEA Games in Thailand and other international competition in 2026?
Of course, I agree with you that it is important to send our Filipino athletes abroad. And that is also one of the goals of Go for Gold as a cycling team, as a continental team, is to give our athletes international exposure, not just in Criterium. In fact, one of our athletes this year, si John Andre Aguja, is right now ranked number 7 or 8 in the world. So that's against the whole world, number 1 in Asia. One of our goals with him is to definitely give him more international experience. We're trying to get him a US visa now so that he can compete in America in April. And then hopefully compete in the Asian Cycling Championship and then to the World Championships in August this year. So that it's something that we definitely put a budget on, but kailangan yung cyclist has to prove himself here locally first bago siya pumunta abroad.
You know, cycling is certified producers in international cycling competition as well as SEA Games. Now, under your stewardship, how will you foresee the bright future of Filipino cyclists? Can they sustain their long quest for personal glory and give more honors to the Philippines as well as satisfy Mr. Bumble Tolentino, the current Vice Philippine Cycling President?
For me, in partnership definitely with Phil Cycling, we are happy to support our Filipino cyclists as they go abroad. And as I mentioned earlier, in partnership with all the other supporters and continental teams, we all work together in order to uplift Philippine cycling. There's a saying, di ba? A rising tide lifts all boats. Mm-hmm. So in order for us to improve, we need to improve cycling in the Philippines in general. That's why we're always very open when we do these events to all other teams, all other sponsors to come to help us. Hindi tayo madamot because alam naman natin hindi natin kayang gawin mag-isa. And kumare maraming ang mga talented na siklista dyan, hindi naman natin kayang supportahan lahat.
You know, Jeremy, I covered Marlboro Tour for more than almost 15 years in 5 consecutive years Ronda Pilipinas. In 3 consecutive years, Litour Pilipinas. Now, during that time, Filipinos reigned supreme. They win, they achieved more honors in that competition. against their foreign rivals. Mm. Now, can our cyclists of today, the current generation of cyclists, duplicate the fate of their predecessors?
I believe so. Siyempre, hindi lang road cycling ang tinitingnan natin. We also need to look at mga other aspects of cycling. Like I mentioned, sa mountain bike, we're actually doing very, very well. And I believe that our Filipino mountain bikers have proven that they can excel abroad and even compete against the best like the Japanese. And I think na-mentioned earlier, one of our young Filipina riders is now coached by a Japanese Olympian. So, pataas ang pataas na yung level. Now, if we go to track cycling, syempre, the future will be very bright there eventually once we get our own velodrome. And then sa road, it's just a matter really, I believe, of development. Diba? We just really need to give more support, more exposure. At the end of the day, sports nga is still about money. And then the other countries, they spend a lot of money on this. So we maghahabol talaga tayo, but we'll get there.
There are 2 months.